Hi everyone, I'm gonna talk about how to use unit conversion method to convert between units. So let's look at this question. Convert 0.10 centimeter to inch. In the question, they always give you the conversion factor for specific for that question, or in the top of the question set, they write all the conversion factors. Make sure to memorize the prefixes that I mentioned and is highlighted in the PowerPoint to memorize those. I'm not gonna provide those prefixes in the exam. So as I said, the conversion factor is given in the question. And always we should have a solution map for it. I recommend you at the beginning follow the solution map. When you are good, when you think that you can do it without the solution map, you can just do it on your own. The first step in the solution map is basically start with a given number. So my given number here is 0.10 centimeter. So I'm gonna write it down. Then the second one is using conversion factor. So this is the conversion factor is given in the question. I can write this. So when you see this in the question, they ask you basically to write it in this way. So you should write it, one in the top of the other one and flip it one more time. So 1 inch divide by 2.54 centimeter or 2.54 centimeter in 1 inch. Now we should decide which one we want to use here in the next basically part of our equation here. Pay attention, I use the left one here because the unit in the denominator is matching with the last previous numerator is centimeter, right? So these should always match because they can cancel out each other. And then this is gonna be the final unit that is gonna be, we're gonna report it. So if this unit on top of the line is matching what is in the question is asking for, we are done. So we can, if you see here, is the same as what is in the question is asking for, and we can do the calculations. How we do the calculations? We multiply the top ones, 0.10 multiply by 1 inch, and we divide it by 2.54 centimeter. The final answer is in 2 sigfig. Why? These should follow the given number, the number of sigfigs in the given number. I have 2 sigfig in the given number, so my final answer should have 2 sigfig. The conversion factor is never significant because it's exact number, so we don't include these basically significant figures or the numbers in here in my final answer. The next step we're gonna use how to use multiple unit conversions. For example, convert 0.10 centimeter to yard. They provide for you the 2 conversion factor here. The first one, we're gonna write it in the way that we could be able to write it in our equation. 1 inch over 2.54 centimeter or flip it. 2.54 centimeter over 1 inch. So we start with a given number. Then we should see which of these two I should use. You can see that I have a centimeter in the given number. So my denominator in the next part, which is centimeter, should be centimeter, which is matching with my previous numerator. So I'm gonna use the left side, left one here. 1 inch over 2.54 centimeter. So the centimeter cancel out, and then we have 1 inch. Now let's see, is that what he's asking for in the question? No, the question is asking for yard. So we should continue. The next conversion factor is 1 yard equals to 36 inches. So I'm gonna again write it in the two ways that you see here. And now I should decide which one to use. I should use the first one in the left because the denominator is matching the previous numerator and they can cancel out. The final unit in the top is yard. Yes, that's what it's asking for. That. So I'm done. So I can multiply the top numbers and then divide by the numbers in the bottom of the line. When I do the calculations, this is the number point 0010 yard, and it should have two sig fig, which is matching with my given number. Then our final step should be converting to scientific notation. We just make sure convert, we just move the decimal point to convert to scientific notation. The last concept I'm gonna talk about, how to convert units raised to the power. For example, convert 0.10 inch cubic to centimeter cubic. Here in the question, they gave us 1 inch equals to 2.54 centimeter. So rest start with the given, next step, we're gonna start with a given number. Here I have the given number, but if I just write 1 inch over, I mean, or 2.54 centimeter over 1 inch, the units will not match. This is inch cubic, but this is inch only here. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put in the parentheses and put the parentheses to the power of 3. This way, we make sure we're gonna see that the inch in the bottom goes to the power of 3, the centimeter goes to the power of 3, and also the number inside the parentheses goes to the power of 3. So we do that to be able to make sure our units now are matching. I have inch cubic here and I have inch cubic in the next denominator. So I just want to emphasize here that the number in the parentheses, because it's in the power of 3, should also make sure we include it in the calculations when we raise it to the power of 3. And then if you do the calculations with your calculator, you will see the answer would be 1.6 centimeter cubic, and the answer should have only 2 significant figures, which is matching with the sig fig in the given number. That's it all for this concept.